Welcome everyone to this in-depth review of these brand new PCIe capture cards, the EverMedia Livestreamer Ultra HD and the LiveGamer 4K 2.1. In this video, we'll dissect the design, performance, unique features, as well as disadvantages of each card to help you make an informed decision based on your streaming or gaming needs. Now, let's start by unboxing the budget-friendly EverMedia GC571 aka Livestreamer Ultra HD card. Opening the packaging, you can directly see instructions on how to connect the card and a QR code to download the software, which is really nice. You also get an HDMI cable and some extra instructions in the box. The Livestreamer Ultra HD is catering to those who are either new to live streaming or prefer a budget-friendly solution without compromising on performance. The compact form factor and low-profile PCB design can be installed to any PCIe X1 slot, so it will not be a problem installing it basically to just any motherboard. Stepping into the performance realm, the Livestreamer Ultra HD delivers on its promise of excellent value, offering smooth captures of up to 30fps at 2160p, 60fps at 1440p, and 120fps at 1080p with remarkable precision and clarity. This card strikes a balance between affordability and performance, making it an ideal choice for content creators seeking an entry-level solution without compromising quality. Some standout features of the Livestreamer Ultra HD are its variable refresh rate, or VRR, HDR support and high FPS support in video pass-through. This provides a visually stunning experience, eliminating judder and frame tearing for a smoother and more responsive content creation process, adding vibrancy to visuals and enhancing the overall viewing experience. It supports uncompressed video pass-through at 4K 60 in HDR and VRR, 1440p 144 in HDR and VRR, 1080p 240 in HDR VRR, and ultra-wide 1440p at 100Hz. Now let's shift our focus to the high-end side, the LiveGamer 4K 2.1. Featuring HDMI 2.1 support, this card caters to the desires of modern gamers who seek enhanced resolutions and rapid refresh rates. With 4K 144 and 4K 120 HDR pass-through, the LiveGamer 4K 2.1 establishes itself as a premier consumer-graded capture card and makes it possible for the first time to capture and game at the same time in HDR. Now, opening the packaging, we see a similar pattern, having instructions on how to connect it directly after opening it. The main difference, apart from the card itself, is the included HDMI cable, which is HDMI 2.1 compatible. For gamers seeking to elevate their gameplay, the LiveGamer 4K 2.1 offers support for refresh rates up to 144Hz in 2160p, 240Hz in 1440p, and an astonishing 360Hz in 1080p HDR and VRR pass-through. VRR, which stands for Variable Refresh Rate, will provide ultra-smooth gameplay and lag-free performance, addressing issues like lag, ghosting, and screen tearing. The LiveGamer 4K 2.1 solidifies its position with a direct and stable connection through a PCIe X4 slot. Here you must be careful because you will need a free PCIe X4 slot on your motherboard, ensuring superior data transfer rates and minimizing delays. In addition to the already mentioned features, the customizable RGB lighting allows users to sync the card seamlessly with major gaming RGB ecosystems, adding a personal touch to your streaming setup. You should consider buying the LiveGamer 4K 2.1 if you are a gaming enthusiast or professional streamer seeking top-notch performance and the latest HDMI 2.1 technology. The card's support for ultra-high refresh rates and resolutions enhances the overall gaming experience, making it an excellent choice for those who prioritize performance and a seamless gaming experience on just any console or PC. Now, the biggest drawback this capture card has is that it can only support HDR recording at 2160p with 30fps, which is basically a downgrade from the previous generation 4K capture card, which supported 4K 60 HDR capture. Now here they of course added VRR support and higher pass-through signal support, which was not possible before, but still, there is this one feature that is considered a downgrade and some of you may not be really happy about it. In conclusion, both the EverMedia Livestreamer Ultra HD and the LiveGamer 4K 2.1 bring distinct advantages to the table. The Ultra HD caters to entry-level streamers with budget constraints, offering a balanced mix of performance and affordability. On the other hand, the LiveGamer 4K 2.1 targets gaming enthusiasts with its advanced HDMI 2.1 features and customizable RGB lighting. Carefully consider your streaming or gaming requirements, budget constraints, and desired features before making a choice that aligns with your aspirations, ensuring a seamless and enjoyable content creation or gaming experience. Now, I should note here that this was not a paid advertisement, but we did get the products for free to review them, and is our honest opinion and experience with the products. Personally, I have been using the AverMedia Live Gamer 4K for over 4 years, and it works amazing, still having no issue at all. Here, I just want to let you know that if you want to buy one of these cards, you will find an affiliate link in the description below. So that was it for today. If you have anything to ask about the product, write me in the comments below. Leave a like and subscribe to our channel if you want to see more reviews. See you on the next one.